This episode of In an Instant was made possible by Supersense. Check out their amazing analog offerings at supersense.com.
Welcome to In an Instant. My name is Ben.
I'm Chris Holmquist from Supersense.
And today we are going to make our own pack film. How in the world are we going to be able to do that, Chris?
Well, with the new One Instant DIY film kit.
It's quite an unbelievable creation by Supersense that is putting the power back in the people's hands to craft pack film yourself. Really gives you a good understanding of A, how the film works, B, why it's so difficult to produce this at scale, and C, it's just a fun, creative way to be involved in your own creative process. So today we're gonna walk you through sort of the backstory of Supersense, what this film is, how to make it yourself, and then we'll shoot a little bit with it. So we'll catch you after the intro.
The kind of photography that would become part of the human being. Press a button and have the picture.
We are here in the studio with Chris Holmquist of Supersense. Very exciting opportunity to get you in here all the way from Vienna, where the manufacturing of Supersense is located. And why don't you tell us a little bit about what Supersense is and the product that it's more or less saving.
Okay, well, first off, thanks for having me.
Our
and
pleasure.
Helping us launch this product. Yeah, Supersense is kind of the brainchild of my boss, Florian Doc Kaps. The idea is to bring the senses to a line of analog products, and you could say I'm sort of the photo department. So, you know, our product, One Instant, grew out of like the save pack film movement, let's say. Yeah, it's called a movement if we can. You probably know Packfilm was discontinued by Fuji in 2016. Before that, of course, was produced by Polaroid, going back to the 60s. Basically, we hate to see any format die and wanted to keep it alive. And so One Instant is that. Kind of rethinking how we can make it, doing it on a much smaller handmade scale. No big machines, just people folding paper and keeping it really simple and analog.
Yeah. So with Packfilm having gone extinct and a lot of the machinery being lost, especially FujiFilm, who had the last machines, what materials does One Instant utilize to even make the Packfilm, given all of it has gone extinct?
Sure. Well, the most crucial parts are kind of new old stock, let's say Polaroid materials. And we get those through our partners at the 20 by 24 studio. 20 by 24 studio, since the late 70s, was a part of Polaroid, kind of a showcase for what their materials can do. In 2008, as Polaroid was kind of shuttering its doors, they purchased a large amount of film, paper, a pod machine, and the chemistry to make the reagent. So all of the stuff we're using at this time is from them, and they have a big stockpile.
So the contents of the pods, though, while the pod foil is coming from 20 by 24 Studio, The contents of the pods are actually fresh.
That's right, yeah. So they are mixed fresh for each batch, like a bakery. Not as frequently, not as early in the morning, but yeah. So, you know, and some of the chemistry originally was from Polaroid, but as time has gone on and those things have run out, they have reformulated. And at the moment, our black and white reagent is a completely like new formulation from scratch that those guys came up with, and you know, brilliant for doing that. And which is exciting for the future, because that is our whole goal, is to kind of give this a sustainable and see that it can be made in the future. So, you know, there's still a lot left to do, but that's our goal.
So maybe tell me a little bit about why you developed this DIY product and why it might help the long-term success of the project.
Sure. Well, the cost that's in the product is, a lot of it comes from labor. In reality, it's 15 to 20 minutes to make one. We said, what if the customer could do more of it? And there's some practical problems, because we use a darkroom with infrared light and goggles to do a lot of the light sensitive steps. After quite a bit of thinking, tinkering, and development of this new idea, we did come up with a way to, we put the negative in an envelope. Everything else then can be done by the customer or the shooter. And not only is it, I think, fun to do it, you get a better understanding of how it works and like what's going on in there, because it's very interesting. But it saves us labor, which in the end saves the customer money. It's part of an idea to just make it more sustainable. Mm-hmm. Because I think if we can lower the price, we can sell more, it grows from there. People or it's more accessible, basically.
Yeah. All right, well, all that being said, I would really love for you to walk us through how exactly to construct our own Packfilm.
Yeah, it'd be my pleasure.
All right, let's do it.
All right. So, this is what you'll get, an 8-pack. This is the all-important envelope holding the 8 negative envelopes. Keep that sealed up until you need them. Envelope with all the parts, pods, positive envelopes. Let's start with the cartridge. So this is the positive envelope. So it's got scores and perforations, and all of those should just be folded as nicely as possible and bent all the way down. The edge of a table helps. Isn't necessary, but kind of want to loosen up the folds here. Now we're going to use a strip of the mounting tape. This is just a double-backed, double-sided adhesive tape. So that goes on this end flap. Basically, you want the edge of this flap to be flush with the this side of the positive envelope. Take your tool and really get in there and put some pressure on it to make sure you're getting a really good adhesive contact. Break it in. That'll just sort of relax the folds a bit and it reduce the chance that it's gonna pop open later. So then we can put two of the mounting tape strips on the top of this, just sort of towards the edges. It's not super critical. And then on the back, we're gonna put one of these sticky dots, which later will hold the positive goo trap. So that's a completed positive envelope. Next up, the cap. So the cap is made out of lightproof paper, the same stuff we use for the negative envelope. So it's got two folds running this way and then a couple on each side here. And then there's a little tricky origami 45 degree fold. I'm sure that just taught no one how to do that. So give it a little tug, just make sure it's, you know, nicely locked in there. And that is a completed cap. So set that aside. So next up is what we call the positive assembly. There's a matte side, which is the back, and the glossy side, which is the business end. That's where the print goes. So first thing is the positive leader or positive puller. It's easiest to set that down with the adhesive face up, take the positive shiny side down, and line that up with the adhesive tape that's there. Now you want to put a hard fold along that edge. So just kind of roll it back, make sure everything's square and parallel. Now we have the positive goo trap. Put the positive face down and just line it up with the tape. Next, we have the trap spacer, as we call it, but I've been told by guys at the 20 by 24 studio that they were called blibbits at Polaroid, which I think is a much better name. So now it's time for the rails. So these also have the low tack adhesive. Line them up where the fold is, where the edge of the positive paper is. So that's the positive assembly ready to go. So now it's all about putting this together, which means we have to get out the negative envelope. So the reason that these are in a black envelope is just to minimize light exposure. And you definitely shouldn't take them out until you're gonna use one, which you're gonna then cap and put away to be shot. Okay. So on one side, you've got the negative leader or negative puller, and on the other side, you've got the dark slide. There's two sets of notches, one for the positive assembly, one for the pod. First thing is put the positive assembly face down, line it up with these notches on the far side, and at this point, it helps to put like a weight or something on here. So like a little sandbag, but actually a phone works great for this. Whatever brand of phone you might have in your pocket, maybe a BlackBerry or a Motorola Razr or a Nokia, okay. And then we're gonna take this attachment tape and that's gonna hold that down. I think the point here is actually for you to get familiar with the system and feel like you understand it a bit, so feel free to experiment. All right, so fold that out of the way, and now you're gonna put the pod on. So the pods are pre-cut and pre-taped, so there's a adhesive strip here with some backing paper. That is going to be lined up with these notches. Now you definitely want to burnish this and get some good contact, but you want to be very careful not to burst the pod, obviously. Since the adhesive's only on this one side, just focus there, just slow and firm, and do your best not to break that open. Now it's time to put it all together. So take the positive envelope and peel off the backing paper here. And basically the front of the paper on the negative envelope will line up with these, the ends of the positive envelope here. Don't worry about this flap, that doesn't tell you anything that's meant to fold out of the way. So line up this front of the negative envelope with the front of the positive envelope. And of course, have it centered. Do it as nice as you can. Now, I find it easy to just flip it over now, keeping in mind that the pod is here and you don't want to crush that or put any pressure on it. And then coming from the dark slide side, get your tool in there and burnish down the adhesive so it's well adhered. All right, now this is the real tricky part, let's say. First thing, take the negative leader, negative puller, and just feed that through to where you can grab it from the other side. Now, you wanna keep pulling it in, but you wanna lift this up and let the pod flip around, keeping in mind the whole time that that's kind of a critical zone, so mind the pod. The plastic negative puller is kind of springy there, so just push it down, feed that in, and once you're in there, you know you're good. You can't really do it wrong. Pull it in there, pull the negative puller, make sure that's taut. Peel that off. Now you're gonna stick this down to that adhesive. So, the cap. The cap's tight and it needs to go on kind of nicely and square, otherwise you could rip it in these corners. But it's a little finicky. So what I would say is ease into it. Okay, there we go. So, and you know it's on when like this line covers up the old piece of paper that used to be there. So make sure it's fully seated. Look at that. Then turn it around. There's some adhesive left from that sticky dot. Push that down and that'll keep your cap on nice and tight. And there you go. A one instant cartridge that you made yourself. Time to shoot.
We first put Chris's handiwork to the test utilizing the one instant DIY Packfilm camera, which he also designed. Chris may seem of sane mind and spirit, but I must say he's crazy for this one. I've never before built a camera with my own bare hands, but that is the task at hand in constructing this sliding box camera. If you like making your own film, making your own camera to shoot the film you made yourself is a good way to make yourself feel like you're worth being around. Very rewarding process.
Wow.
Wow.
Very good.
That's really nice. What did Michelangelo say when he gave up on that statue he'd been working on?
What?
It's a bust.
I also ripped some Supersense Choco in the desert. Choco is one of three films Supersense provides, a cross-processed film containing both color and black and white materials to create a film that Willy Wonka would be proud of. Alongside that unique sepia canvas, they also produce a traditional black and white film and their P7 color. Like shooting a single sheet of 8x10, loading single sheets of Supersense crystallizes each shot as a prized individual creation, something I've always loved about One Instant. It's a specialized product, and this is truly a specialized process for it.
All right, well, I think a couple thank yous are in order. First of all, thank you to Supersense, One Instant, you and your team for being the charge, the moment of saving Packfilm. This format is otherwise completely dead, and Supersense is on the front lines trying to figure out the logistics of how to make this film format possible. So thank you for that, and also thank you for coming all the way here to show us how to do our own DIY Packfilms. Really incredible, experiential kind of product, and I think artists are gonna get a lot out of it. So. What's next for this project?
Well, we're just curious how it kind of lands. So we want to know from the shooters and, you know, do they want to spend more time making their own film? Is this a benefit or is this a bug? A bug or a feature, I guess.
Yeah.
So we're super interested in that. You know, please write to me. If you write to Supersense, you know, it'll get to me. We like hearing complaints, compliments, whatever you got, let us know.
Yeah, I think the community is very much a part of this product in particular, because what people do with this could help shape the future of Packfilm. So everybody, put your money where your mouth is. This is the time to like support this cause, figure out some interesting solutions. You have the materials now. And thanks again, Chris.
Yeah, and thank you to all the shooters out there, because it would be nothing without you.
So. We'd be nothing in general.
Yeah,
we're nothing with you, frankly. Well, thank you for watching In an Instant. Go ahead and DIY your own subscribe button. Stay tuned for more interviews, reviews, breakdowns, and all things Instant. Bye.